Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player. Good day, all. Ira Epstein of Linn Associates with your financial market wrap-up for this Tuesday, December 18th, 2018. We're just getting on past 3:35 p.m. Central Standard Time, and I wanted you to see where the markets were at this hour. Now, they're going to close higher. In other words, the settlement's higher because 20 minutes or so ago, we saw the settlement, and it was a bit better than this. The markets gave up an awful lot in the day. They were everywhere today. One of the problems has been all day long, the energy prices, down nearly 7-8% just today alone. Then we look at to see that we're still getting bids in the bonds and the notes. You have the FOMC tomorrow. What I think hurt this market, the crude oil market today, was the Chinese speech today in the Great Hall, where there was a celebration and President Xi, he didn't offer reforms. In fact, if anything, in the speech, he was a bit defiant. Nobody's going to tell China basically what to do. They're going to move at their own pace. They'll reform what they think needs reform, not what the others think they should reform. I can go on and on. The market didn't like that because what does China do? It imports a lot of energy. It also uses a lot of copper. Yeah, you're seeing this correct, almost 10 cents lower per pound of copper. These are big moves, and the only thing I can take is the market got nervous from this speech. So, as we all know, tomorrow's the big FOMC meeting. It takes place at 1 o'clock Central Standard Time with the statement release. Then about 1:30, the press conference. The market is widely expecting a quarter point hike. The market is expecting a much more dovish Fed. Any of those things that are deviated from there creates a market issue. When we take a look at a weekly area chart of closes, you can see how this market's gone from 29.34 to this low point. Now, we're not at the end of a week, but at this exact moment, we're at 25.34. You're down 400 S&P points. That's a monster break. And this market is in bear market territory. It's that simple. When we look at the daily bar chart, you can see how the market's worked itself down in waves on a daily basis with a high, another high, then the arrows show the most recent highs, and certainly lower lows, the definition of a downtrend. On rallies back up, I would expect a resistance point if it gets there, and I'm sure many of you are saying, let it get there, I want to get out of this market, at 26.67, and from where you're at now, that's 130 some odd points away. In terms of Bollinger Bands, if you'll notice, the market got under the Bollinger Band yesterday, and as I said, I believe it's going to close higher than this, settle, so it'll be over the lower Bollinger Band most likely. The problem is, as a bear, it's riding the band down in an oversold territory, and it's pushed that band to the sideways area. To get back to unchanged on the year, you have to get to 26.85, that's 150 points. I don't know what's going to make that happen. It could be a Fed surprise. It could. I was hoping it would be something out of China. I think China's off the table this year, so now it's either the Fed or I don't see anything that does that. When we come to the NASDAQ, you've come right back to unchanged on the year, challenging the lower Bollinger Band, and like the S&P, oversold. Unlike the S&P, it has a pattern of a higher high and a lower low, and I think you'd see that when you look at this 18-day average of closes, as I say, it's the line in the sand. It's often a zone if the market falls where it works back to and tries to figure out what it's going to do next. That's what's happened here. When we come on to the Dow, this is more like the S&P. You've had the spike, then a high, another high, another high. Then you got under the yearly close and you haven't looked back. This market, admittedly, it's a daily chart, but it's got a whole series, what, 4 or 5 days in a row now under that. But like the other indices, oversold, and definitely at this point at least paying attention to the support offered by the lower Bollinger Band in that when that target's hit, the market often stalls. When you come to the Russell, this has been riding the lower Bollinger Band. It's a complete different chart.
than the others in both its makeup and what it's doing. It has an embedded reading. The numbers are staying under 20, both the K and the D lines. It doesn't even bounce far away from the lower Bollinger Band. It's just leaking away. It was at 1541.60 at the end of 2017. We're now 70 points away on that. It's quite a rally to get back up to. In the VIX, I think the pros were going short today, but obviously it's a dangerous play, calls, and that's what I think they were shorting on the upper Bollinger Band. They might have also sold the futures. You know, if you trade those, they might have gone there looking for the market to come back. In the T-bond market, I have been looking for a break in this market, and I'm clearly, at this point, not right. The market got over 143.31. It made a higher high. So this is one of those instances when where you lose the embedded reading. Normally, I look for the market for price and the 18-day average to challenge each other. But my caveat is I don't want to see the previous high taken out, and that becomes one of the risk factors. And that market took it out. This is a trade the plane. Didn't work. It looks like you're on goal to do similar in the 10-year note, where the market is going to try to get over that 120-30 level. You know, we're sitting here at a 282 handle for all purposes. You were 3.25%, now you're 2.8, and people are saying that this is a bear stock market. The economy's turned the corner into bearishness. I realize a number of traders in marketplace are saying opposite. They're saying, you know, the PEs have come down, the fundamentals aren't that radically different, and while the chart action's bearish, the underlying fundamentals aren't as bearish as that. There's something for everybody to talk about. My job here is not to tell you do this or do that. I just point the things out. TLT never did lose that embedded reading, and it's now at new highs on the move. The dollar index got back to the 18-day average today, and it's just hanging there. That's what I'd expect. Neutral in front of the Fed. So you got a higher high, and today you made the lower lows. You're totally neutral on this chart. Momentum pointing down, bias up because you're over the 18-day average and no trend. In the eurocurrency, you got up high enough here with a high today of 114.93 to take out for 114.88.5. You're no longer in a downtrend. Again, right in front of the Fed, lower and low, higher high, pretty flat momentum as well. British pound is in a reaction to the upside. 5% of the time you stay under a Bollinger Band. You see you got under it for 3 days here, popped back up 4 days ago or so, and now you're making your challenge of the 18-day average of closes where I'd expect to see the resistance. Close over that, and surprisingly, I would say join the bull camp for a bit. It's difficult, I know, with the January 7th election coming up. They're going to discuss again the debate January 7th, and I think it's the 14th, the vote in Parliament again. And all the plans are for a Brexit hard landing right now. In the Japanese yen, prices drove back up to the upper Bollinger Band. This is one of those safe haven plays like the bonds and the notes. People are scared. They're buying this market as it's coming up. You certainly can't tell me they're buying the Japanese economy, but this is an unrelated currency, so they took it up. The market did not get over a previous high. This is your resistance point, and it didn't follow through to the lower Bollinger Band. Momentum up, bias up, swing line down, and at a resistance point. In Bitcoin, you lost the embedded reading. We talked about that. Here you are on Monday. Today you lose it. I said last night, when it opens, it's probably going to be lost. And that's how the math works on this. You always look to see where in the range you are and how close to losing the embedded reading. And you lost it. So I'm now looking for price and the 18-day average to come together. And I'll call this the pause in a market that had one heck of a break. Was that it? I don't know. But I think the bear phase of this part of it has come to an end. In the Brent versus WTI crude, we're just producing oil like there's no tomorrow. I realize China's one of the events, but if you read what the EIA is saying, 8 million barrels a day we're producing here. So up and away you go on the differential. And the differential is because what's going on is Brent, we know that OPEC wants to cut. I'm seeing nothing in the U.S. And keep in the back of your mind, we have a number of pipelines in 2019 that come online. Now, the problem is there is a number at which a number of U.S. Permian Basin producers can't make money. We're probably getting to that for some. Something to keep in the back of your mind. And obviously, if they can't make money, they stop production, and that creates its own bottom. Too high of prices create tops, too low create bottoms. You got a higher high, lower low. We were trying that sideways action. I was much more convinced yesterday that we were going to get more sideways action. Was this a false breakout or not to the downside? You're oversold. We'll find out tomorrow. The odds favor the market's going to try to get back within the lower Bollinger Bands unless the Fed surprises the market in some way. WTI, same thing, under everything and oversold. Rebob gasoline, look at this. I mean, for the U.S. consumer, this is a dream. Your gasoline prices, go outside, take a look. They're cheap. It's a tax savings one way or the other. How long it lasts, unfortunately, well, it is the Christmas driving season in many parts of the country. That's good, but it's certainly not spring or summer. In that gas, getting a little bounce of some more cold weather coming in. Plus, you had spent 2 days under the lower Bollinger Band. What do you hear me say all the time? Markets that get under it try to come back over it because 95% of the time they trade within the bands and you were close to that 100-day average. So you've got two support levels and you did get the bounce that we were talking about from there. That's the way that I'm looking at it. Want to remind you about my charting course. If you like what I do here, I can teach you how to do this, add more tools to it, and do it for a price you're not going to get anywhere else. All right? It's $99.95 for 54 videos, 6 hours of video time. You see what I do, and then with the charting software we give you and the data in it, you do the same thing I'm doing. Then you're going to say, well, that's fine, Ira. Those videos were from X period back. I agree with you. So every morning I bring you up with the current markets. And now you're seeing how to swing lines work, how to put window envelopes, different tricks with the Bollinger Bands, the slow stochastics, trades against the trend, throwing out ideas on trades for you. So I do that each morning. It's about a 15-minute video. You get in the habit of watching it. It's done in the same way each time. I start off with stock indices, move on to the currencies, interest rates, so on and so forth, right through the soft and the energy market. So I really cover all the spectrum. So you get the whole course. You can start it when you'd like. It's a great gift if you give it to somebody. How do you get this? Well, either call my staff, they'll set it up for you, or you can go right online, www.irapstein.com. If you go online, go under the word education. If you have any trouble doing it, just call us at this number. We'll work it all out for you. I'm Ira Epstein. You have a good day, and I'll see you tomorrow.